Hi viewers, I'm Nadim.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Welcome to the Farooq Academy. Today we will discuss chapter number 3, book D2, exercise 3C, expansion and factorization of algebraic expression. Question number 1. Please, my dear students, open your textbook and see exercise 3C. First question, A part. Expand each of the following, a plus 4 whole square. So, my dear students, there are two methods to solve such type of questions. First method is very simple, that we have to write 2 times the same bracket, then multiply first term with the second one and take second part of first term will be multiplied as we have discussed in previous lectures. So, multiply it, a square, bases are the same, power should be added, then 4a. Now, first, we have completed step. Now, second step, 4a plus 4a, and then 4 are 16. So, similar terms will be added with each other, so you will get 5, 4 and 4, 8a. Plus 16. So here is your result. Now coming to the other part. For example, I part 5x minus 3 whole square. So again, as we have discussed earlier, that we can solve this type of question in a two methods, but we have a simple method, so we use that method, that is 5x minus 3, write down in this form, and we have to write 2 times, so multiply by the same method, you will get 5 are 25, x square, here power is 1, so bases are the same, power should be added. We are discussing about the variables, so x, y are considered to be the variables 1, so you will get 25x square. Similarly, minus 5 3s are 15x. Then minus 3 multiplied with this one and with this one, you will get 15x, and minus minus become positive, 3 3 is 9. Now similar terms will be added with each other, 25x square minus 30 minus 30x and plus 9. So here is your result. Now my dear students, next part of this question, that is last part, J part, 4 minus 3t whole square. Okay, write down 2 times 4 minus 3t into 4 minus 3t and multiply it by the same method, repeat the same method, same steps. You will get 4 4s are 16 minus 4 3s are 12t. Similarly, minus 4 3s are 12t. And minus minus in multiplication become positive, so 3 3 is a 9t square. So similar terms will be added, so you will get 16 minus 24t and plus 9t square. So here is your result. This is the simple methodology. Now we have discussed that this type of questions can be solved by the two methods. So second method I would like to quote here in a simple way, so that you understand in a better way. No problem, if you use any method, it will be a legible method, no problem. That is 4 minus 3t whole square. You are well familiar to this fact that a plus b or a minus b having whole square, so you will get a square, then plus b square, then minus 2ab. So this is the basic formula, so we can expand the given question in this formula, that is, for example, that is your a and that is your b, so expand a square, 4a square, then b square, b is 3t square, 2ab, then again here is your a and here is your b, that one is your b, so 3t. So expand 4 square mean 4 4s are 16 and plus 9t square, and then multiplied with this, you will get 4 2s are 8, 8 3s are 24t. So you will get the same result, no problem. Now coming to the question number 2. Expand each of the following. Again the same type of questions, no problem. You can also solve this question in a 2 method. Question number 2. That is where suppose a part, expand each of the following, 2x minus 5 and 2x plus 5. So now you see here you have to multiply it with this one and with this one, similarly with this one and with this one. This is the first method. So when you multiply you will get 4x square, 10x, and then 5 twos are 10x, and then 5 fives are 15, 5 fives are 25. So minus minus plus minus, so in multiplication minus sign often wins. So the similar term you see minus 10x and plus 10x, so it will be cancelled with each other, so you will get 4x square and minus 25. So here is one method. So second method we have to discuss here also. In second method you have a formula that is known as difference of two square formula. It will be equal to a plus b and a minus b. So my dear students, you have given the right side form a plus b and a minus b, you see here. So if you reverse the step, if you reverse the steps, so you will get, and this will be equal to a square minus b square. So it will become, for example, this is your given question, so put here, and a minus b actually is 2x minus 5. So this will be equal to a square, here is your a part, and b, similarly a and b, so a plus b, a minus b, so it becomes a square, a is 2x whole square and minus b is 5 whole square. So you see here 5 fives are 25 minus 4x square. So again the same result is obtained by the same method. You see, by two different methods you will get the same result. So that is your second method. Now it is up to you which method you like and you can use to solve this question. Now other parts of this question, for example f part, you have been asked 2h minus k into 2h plus k. So this will be equal to, by using this formula, a minus b, a plus b, which is equal to a square minus b square. So this implies that 2h square, by reversing this given question into this formula, so you will get a square minus b square, b is k. So by simplifying, 2 2's are 4h square minus k square. So here is your result. Now other part also I would like to solve to clear the conception. For example, another difficult part, a square minus y into x square plus y. So you see here again a minus b into a plus b, this will be equal to a square minus b square. So by putting the values in this formula you will get that here is your a square, that is your x square is a, and minus b, the term b is known as, you see here y, this one is b term, this one is your b term, and this one is your a term, and similarly by solving this minus b whole square. So by simplifying, you know that law of power of power, you know the law of power of power, both the powers should be multiplied with each other, so you will get x4 minus b square. So here is your result. Now coming to the question number 3, use the algebraic identities to solve this. Question number 3, use the algebraic identities. Use the algebraic. Question number 3, a part, that is 502 cross 498. So my dear students, we have to put the given question in difference of two square formula which we have discussed just now. You see 502 means 500 plus 2. Similarly, 498 means 500 minus 2. So we can write the given numbers like as. So you know this is your a plus b and this is your a minus b, and that will be equal to a square minus b square, difference of two square formula. So putting the values here, the a is 500 and b is 2. So 5 5s are 25 and it will become, and 4 4, 2 2s are 4. So you will get the result, that is after minus you will get 249996. Here is your answer. So by the same method, another part I would like to solve for you, that is h part 805 square. So how to solve this question? 800 plus 5 you can also write as, no problem. For example, you see here 800, it can be written as whole square. So such type of questions, you have a formula, that is a plus b whole square, which is equal to a square plus b square plus 2ab. So you can use this formula here. Here is your a and this one is your b. So a square, a is 800, putting the values, substituting the values, b is 5 square plus 2 a once again 800 and b is 5, so you will get 64,000 plus 25 plus this one becomes 800, you will get plus 25. So by adding, you can use simple calculator to add this, you will get the result approximately 648025, approximately that is your answer. So actually, my dear students, you have to emphasize on the methodology, that what is the method, which kind of formula here is essential to be used, or you must learn this formula, otherwise these questions, such type of question cannot be solved so much easily. It is not a simple method that you take the calculator and sum all these and you can find the square by the help of calculator. No, it is the algebraic expression, so you have to solve in algebraic form. You should use this formula, which is very much necessary to be learned by heart, then you will be able to solve such type of questions. Now similarly, if I would like to solve another part, now we are coming to the next question, that is question number 4. If x square plus y square is equal to 14 and xy is equal to 5, then find the value of x plus y whole square. So we have to find the value of this. So my dear students, first of all we have to learn the formula, that this will be equal to a square plus b square plus 2ab. So here is your formula. Now you see here, if we write as x square plus y square plus 2xy, no problem. You have been given xy 5, so put here plus 2 into 5, and the value of x square plus y square being given, so put here, because this one is x square plus y square, so when you're putting the values, that is given to 14. Now adding these, you see here 14 plus 5 2s are 10, you will get 14 plus 10 you will get 24. So 24 is your answer. Similarly, another question you see here, question number 5 by the same method, question number 6 you can see here, that is, if x square plus y square is equal to 86 and xy is equal to minus 16, then find the value of x minus y whole square. So we have to find the value of, since we are well familiar to this fact that x minus y whole square is equal to a square, similarly plus b square minus 2ab. So it is our basic formula. So we have all the values here, no problem, you have to put the values here, just like that one is your this one. So putting the values, you see here it is 86, then minus 2 into xy. The value of xy is here, you have to put here, that is minus 16. So simplify it, 86 and minus minus become positive and it is 32. So you will get 8, 9, 10, 11. So 118 is your result. Now coming to the question number 7, having the same method, no any change being seen. Now question number 8 is considered to be the different one and we have to solve it. Question number 8, using the algebraic expression or using the algebraic rules and without using calculator to evaluate. For example, this part we seen, that is 236 and equal to 236 whole square minus 238 cross 234. So my dear students, how can I write in algebraic form, that is 236 can be written as in square form, and you see here how can I use to simplify the basic rules, that is 236 whole square, that is minus 238, that is 238 can be written as 236 plus 2, so it becomes 238. Similarly, the product sign is can be shifted like this, bracket means also multiplication. So 234 is 236 minus 2. So why I do this? Because I am trying to reproduce 236 many times, because here you see I have to reproduce 236 236, because already we have 236. So I am trying to produce 236 again. So I can use the difference of two square formula, that is a square minus b square is equal to a plus b into a minus b. So we are trying to reproduce such type of formula. So we have been succeeded to reproduce. So here are 236 can be seen here, that is 236, and this one can be used like this to reverse this formula, or having the solution left hand side, because if we see that is your a part and that is your b, so a plus b and a minus b. So you see here I can write as 236 by the same method, and this one is equal to 236 square and minus 2 whole. So this is the reversal of this formula, or reverse step of this formula, to reproduce it like this in a numbers form, in a numerical form. So you will get 236 and this one is your minus, so it means this one can be cancelled with this one. So only you have here 2 2s are 4, that is your result, that is which you will get the minus 2 8. So this one 2 2s are 4, or 2 power 2 means 4, so you can write as here 4. So my dear students, you see here if we plus minus, and a little problem to be seen here, my dear students, we have used this here, but we have a limited values, that is negative sign. So whenever we find a negative sign here are the brackets, so we have to be careful in about brackets, because negative sign can affect, it becomes negative and this will become positive. So we have to make another step for the clarity, otherwise it will create confusions to the students, that they may, that minus 236 square and it becomes positive 224. So after clarity you can understand in a better way, otherwise it will produce a confusion, that how is it possible that negative sign cannot be neglected. So it is clear that 236 whole square minus, now it is clear. So this will be cancelled with this one, only you will get 236 divided by 4, and you will get the result in your simple calculator. You will get approximately 5 4s are 20 and 5 9 4s are 36, so 59 is your answer. So we have completed question number 8. Now question number 9, last part of this exercise, last question, question number 9. You see the figure ABCD, here is your figure, you see like this in your textbook, and you can see that is your 4x minus 3 and that is your 5x plus 6, here is your 3x, and ABCD, A that is your 90 angle, BCD. Now in this given picture, the figure ABCD shows a trapezium. How to find, show that the area of a trapezium can be expressed as. So my dear students, the area of a trapezium is equal to half area of trapezium. You know my dear students, area of trapezium is equal to half sum of parallel sides, sum of parallel sides into height. So that is your area of the trapezium formula. So putting the values, no problem. Here the sum of sides, you can sum it, no problem. There are two parallel sides, you see here. So sum of parallel side, you can put here 5x plus 6 plus 3x, here sum of parallel side, and into height. So here is your height. So into 4x minus 3. Now simplify it, you will get similar terms will be added, 8x plus 6 and 4x minus 3. So multiplying these two terms with each other, so you will get that is 3x, 5x and 8x. So we are here to simplify it in a simple manner. So you will get, if I use the formula, that is 4x minus 3, and I have to take the common from it, that is I can take 2 common, so we can write 4x plus 3. Why I do this? Because 4x minus 3, so I am trying to make 4x plus 3 also, because I can use the difference of 2 square formula. So that's why it would be very much simple to get the result. Now you see here, after this steps further, this 2 will be cancelled with this one, so you will get 4x. If I do apply the difference of two square formula, you will get 4x square minus b square, it will be equal to, because you know a square minus b square is equal to a plus b into a minus b, difference of two square formula I have applied on it. So that will be equal to 4 4s are 16x square minus 9. So here is your result, because in this question the author of the book asks you that show that the area of a trapezium can be expressed in 16x square minus 9 centimeters square. So we have proved it. So here is your answer. Now my dear students, we have completed exercise 3c. I hope that it will be a very much beneficial to you to understand the clear concept. So thank you very much. Thank you for watching.